So when I become a zombie, I can't do anything. I'm frozen. These pumpkins, they're immune to the zombie grass, so they can move anywhere. Their job is to come and help you.
There's a zombie coming! Okay. I'll save you.
Hi.
Hi. Hello. Welcome to Rutledge.
Welcome to our school.
We're so glad y'all are here.
We're so glad to be here. We can't wait to see your school.
We have some great things to show y'all.
Yeah. Come on.
What is a goal?
What is a goal?
A goal is a dream.
A goal is a dream.
That you can achieve.
That you can achieve.
With strategies.
With strategies.
So can you guys talk a little bit about goals and what is a WIG? Can you explain that a little bit and talk a little bit about goals?
WIG actually stands for Wild Important Goal. Like every year we will set like an academic goal and a non-academic goal. So like you can check in with your teachers and like this is my goal and like this is how I want to achieve my goal.
You know what? I am dreaming big today. I want to learn to play the ukulele. Give me a thumbs up if you think I can do it. Oh, look at all that positive energy. I'm so excited.
They also talk to you that you don't want to set more than a lot of goals because a lot of goals means that you're not focusing on just one goal, which is the goal you want to accomplish.
So I have a big dream, but I don't know how to do it yet. What do you think I could do?
So I think you could practice every day.
Every day. I love it, and that's what I want to do.
You'll see. I know you're looking around. You'll see every class.
That's what I was looking. Yes.
Mission statements and treatment agreements. And
yeah, they all each have their own little.
And dream boards.
Dream boards. I love that.
The second graders are doing stations.
They were just learning in a fun way, playing games.
I love that answer.
Yeah,
that's it exactly. They're practicing their math, but it's fun.
Yeah.
The kids are working on exactly what they need to be working on, and they're getting that practice. You need the practice in math, but they're doing it in a way that's engaging and fun. They get to talk to each other, and I love there was one group of kids talking about how if they get stuck on something, they problem solve it together and they help each other out. And so we're really working on that atmosphere of helping kids get those skills that they really need, that they're going to need when they're grown up.
Problem solve.
Problem solve. I love that.
Oh, my goodness.
Or you can synergize with somebody in the class and they'll help you. Okay, I love it. This format works great for that individualization because they can. They're moving around to different stations. The teacher can set up the stations at the right level of difficulty for the groups. And then she also gets to pull some students to work with her so that she has that time to work in small groups with kids on exactly what they need.
One of the things that we noticed a lot of was little incidents in the classroom that students were having to come to the office to settle with. And I was doing a lot of conflict resolution between kiddos on little things that really weren't office material. What I love the most about it is that it allows each person to have a voice in the conflict. And there's always two sides to every story, right? So it allows both partners to talk through that, get their emotions out, figure out how they're going to make it right, and then walk away with a win-win.
I want this for my house.
Exactly.
Ashton and Eli have used the walkway, and so they're going to just tell us a little bit about how you used it. And you don't have to tell us all the details of your personal conflict, but talk about how you used it.
Basically, how we used it is we had a problem, and since we used this, it helped us, I don't know how you would say it, but, like, helped us with the problem so we don't have to get in, like, this huge argument.
Would you use it again?
Probably.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you, Eli, as an adult, I would love to be able to use this tool, and I think I'm going to ask Ms. Moeller if I can have a copy so that I can take it home with me, because I think it's fabulous. Great job, you guys. Thank you so much for sharing.
And when-